sure seems quiet. Yeah.
Think about hey, Audit, how you doing, man? Welcome to the stream. Thanks for being here.
That's what scares me.
Good, good. I'm glad to hear that. Yeah, I'm good, thank you. I did actually had to take a little break from this because I'm not going to spoil it for you, but an event happened. And let's just say I wasn't too happy with it. I needed like a couple of hours to process it and just, you know, sit back and just try and get my head around it. Yeah. Unless you don't mind spoilers, then I could easily tell you, but I don't know if you're trying to follow the story yourself, like start to finish.
Whoa, is that the QZ? Yep. Watch the high spots.
Trespassers killed on site.
Looks like there's some there.
I just started watching Matcha play it. I don't think he's far behind you. He just entered the mall like areas. Oh, okay, so you know what happens to Joel then, the main character from the first game. I'm struggling to sleep. Keep seeing him. Okay. At the mall. Yeah, he does. And the thing is, I don't expect it because when I was watching the trailers, it felt like they heavily hinted that her girlfriend was going to die and that the revenge mission was going to be about Ellie and Joel was going to be like her conscience, like, oh, you know, you're going too far, Ellie, blah, blah, blah. But I didn't think they actually would go ahead and kill Joel. I was not expecting that, and some words were said. I'm struggling to sleep, keep seeing him in my head. Dinah seems to be sick. I think she's got a cold. I feel calmer with her lying next to me. I want to do something nice for her. Yakima found another camp along the highway. Can't be sure if it was Tommy, but we haven't seen each other in 2 weeks, so fingers crossed. Trespassers killed on site. How many of you are there? How many people have you killed? Oh, you kind of had a feeling that was coming. Ah. Not only do you live in the future, but you can predict the future. Yeah, buy more. Do you mean like shopping center and there's a bunch of clickers inside and you've got to navigate to get through it? Because I know from the demo there is a more you see later on. He had to put my I know exactly what you're talking about. He's got about an hour, maybe half an hour more of gameplay before he gets to that scene. When you get to the gate, look for a soldier named Kieran, tell him I sent you, then give him the kilo. And yeah, so when you get to the scene, you're gonna instantly know what's gonna happen before it happens. So as he's like living the moment, you know, he's gonna think he's gonna be able to save him, and you're, all this time you're gonna be like, ha, 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 I know the truth.
Huh?
do you think of the game so far anyway? Yeah, Macho called it the beginning. Oh, so he thinks... Oh, right, so he has a feeling that's going to happen anyway.
Ellie, what about this?
Guess it won't be much of a shock to him then.
It's pretty picked over.
Jeez, what's this? Infected. Cordyceps has taken over the victim's motor functions. Fast and agile. Stage 1. Infected usually travels in packs. Do not let them swarm you. He said, like, the guitar scene was the last time he's going to see him. Guitar scene. Oh, you mean right at the start? No. You see him again. Uses environment to hide and ambush victims. Will frequently flank and attack from behind. Approach with caution and check your surroundings. Completely blind, acute hearing. Uses echolocation to seek out prey. Keep your distance. Stage 3 infection. Are known for their ferocious attacks and extreme lethal. Like the first one, where he plays her. Oh, yep. You get. Hey, Sebastian, how you doing? Yep, this is KKAIIG. rare but dangerous evolution of stage 3 infected. Incredibly strong and capable of throwing acidic projectiles. Do not engage unless absolutely necessary. Oh, those are the boomer ones. I think Macho is kind of onto something. I mean, that is the last time he plays as him, but it's not the last time you see him. He's got a good half an hour or hour left of our good man, Joel.
Are these cages? Soldiers had them in Boston, too.
Maybe one day, Sebastian. We never know. I gotta go back in an hour. Okay. It was nice having you here anyway, Sebastian. I appreciate that, man. Take care, man. It's always a pleasure having you here.
Dina, help me up here. Okay. See if you can get the gate open from the other side. Sounds good.
What do you think of Abby Ardit? The character with the big giant muscles? I mean, damn, she is a tank. Oh, she is. Although I gotta admit, when I first saw her, I thought, wow, her head's a little bit too small for her body. But damn, like the way she punches enemies and just stomps in their head and just, like, damn, she is brutal. Damn, the views in this game is just, it's just breathtaking. That's what all the people who are that is true. That is true. I mean, it's all good being buff and all that, you know, super strength. But a lot of the time, your head looks too small for your body. At first, I thought it was Ellie with a buff mod. I actually also thought it was Ellie at first. And then I thought maybe it was her mum. And then, nope. Cool. Nothing to do with her. What's this? Chess Master card. Flip. Chess Master, real name, Caleb Sopus. After a run-in with multi-dimensional hero, oh, I still cannot say that name, Tresicutter, criminal mastermind Caleb suddenly could see every possible outcome of his decisions before he's made one. Naming himself Chess Master for his newfound ability to see dozens of moves ahead, this power comes with a cost. Though he made a fortune helping other criminals plan their heist, seeing all the possible outcomes crippled him with indecision. Unable to utilize his power to enrich himself, he is forced to rely on others to make choices for him. Okay, I see. And got a good old letter here. Zelda, once your unit's taken the gate, open it up and coordinate with John's unit. We've got plants in the refuge. My bad, my controller ran out of battery. where was I? Yeah, we've got plants in the refugee line already. I don't want any federal survivors. As soon as you've got control of the area, offer the refugees entry in exchange for loyalty to the WLF. Still don't know what that is. May your survival be long, Isaac. What a nice man. Got hurt. It's at least a broken kneecap.
This was written.
What's this? Got a big operation coming up, and Isaac wants to scavenge any remaining supplies from downtown. Take any gas from the courthouse garage and dome, and take them to the safe house in the Savannah base. Okay. I will do that. Patrol routes. Ration inventory and cleared zones. Any goodies for me? Nope. Oh, I wanted to smash that window.
That's a generator.
Oh, can I not, oh, I've got to turn it on. We just need someone to do jump rope with. I'm just walking my generator. I'll be back soon. honestly, this is what it's like walking my dog. You're just trying to move and he just wants to stay and like sniff something. And just like, come here. Come here, boy. Come here. Come here. Come here. Hello, pizza.
Everything okay? What was that sound?
I got that gate open. Gotta figure out this one now.
Well, we believe in you.
Thanks. Juice.
It needs juice. I need apple juice too. I feel you. I feel you. Should I jump up here? How the hell do I get up there? Did that even reach around there?
Hey, Ellie?
Hey, what's up? That cord won't reach. It looks pretty long. Can you get it over?
Hmm. Oh, forgot about that. Hey. Turns out I'm stupid all this time. Okay. And open sesame. Oh shit. I gotta try and remember the passcode. Oh, Joel's watch. Rest in peace. Okay, checkpoint gate codes. 0512. Thought the horse was gonna die then. Jeez.
Come on. Let's get out of here. That crash was pretty loud. Now what?
I found a note back there. Had some codes on it. It says there's a WLF safe house at some place called Seravina Base.
Seravina. So we find it?
Hopefully we find our first WLF. Get them to talk. Go from there.
Let's do it.
Oh shit, look. Seravina Hotel.
That's gotta be it. Okay. Let's find a way past this, fuck Fedra dude.
Very creative. Gets right to the point. Let's get closer and scope it out.
Sergeant Ward. Continued WLF disruption in our supply line, in addition to affected attacks and spore infestations, means we're still able to meet the weekly food distribution quotas. Keep the city gates sealed to new entrants until further notice. To ease the burden on food stock, step up your sweeps from criminals and expel them. All Class 2 crimes now qualify for expulsion. Expulsion. We're running out of time. LT Taurus. Damn.
Idiots. Just turning everyone against you.
Do you know the code? That note I found has a bunch of them.
Which one's East Gate 2?
We need to get power to the gate first.
Let me see. Okay, East Gate 2 is 5345.
Gas. God damn it. Well, what do we do now? Oh, shit. The note. What? The note mentioned that there's gas in the courthouse garage and the dome. All right. Courthouse garage and the dome. So what's the plan for finding these places? We ride around and see what we see. You think Tommy came through here?
He did.
Damn, that view.
Pretty sure we're here.
Ah, nice. We'll mark it up as we go.
Okay.
What the hell happened out here?
I'm guessing the military bombed the shit out of this place.
Why would they do that?
Well, they would sometimes destroy parts of the city that were lost to the infected. Or to rebels.
That seems like overkill.
Well, it usually worked.
On the infected or the rebels?
Both.
Shit.
Believe me, you're lucky you didn't grow up in a QZ.
I'm starting to get that impression.
What would have happened if I'd stayed? I'd probably just become one more asshole soldier.
No way. I can't see you taking orders from anybody.
Yeah. Good point.
I gotta say, I was expecting the Seattle QZ to be a lot more occupied.
Yeah. I get it all hiding at the Seraphina.
How many WLF you think there are anyway?
Well, at least eight.
If we're lucky, that'll be it.
We'll be fine. We should stay alert. Stock up while we can.
Shimmer's getting sick.
What? How can you tell?
She sounds a little hoarse. Come on, that was a good one.
Come on, Ellie, you love puns.
Check out the tank. I've never seen one of these in action.
Yikes. These guys had a bad day.
What is it?
Burnt skeletons?
Oof. Not how I'd want to go out.
Kinda like those astronauts.
What are you talking about?
One of the early moon missions, there was an electrical fire and the astronauts burned up in their capsule.
Well, at least they died for something worthwhile.
Exactly. These guys were just assholes killed by other assholes.
Roger, following up on our first fight from last night, I hear your concerns and understand your reluctance. But listen, we've thinned out Fedra's numbers. Many of their soldiers have joined our fight. And knowing they plan to seek out through the tunnels, we have a rare opportunity to deal a final blow to the Taurus and his thugs. If we let them regroup, then how many of our men will die? Our own have to come first, and you know that more than anybody. I'm glad you're asking these questions. They are questions leaders wrestle with every day. I'm proud of the growth you've made, the soldier you've become, and the leader you'll be one day, Isaac.
Kind of sad.
Yeah, I guess it is kind of sad. Okay, that's the Russian center.
Distribution center. In Boston, we'd line up for blocks. And the food sucked.
I'd go crazy.
Well, some people did. Come on, let's find a way in.
Use a stun bomb to stun multiple enemies and then finish them off with strike attacks. Very handy. We got fresh intel. There's an active WLF hideout on Spring on 5th. Grab any available soldiers and check your sector and head out to the hideout ASAP. Execute any suspects, secure the location, and wait for my arrival. Sergeant Ward.
Spring and 5th.
Map of Seattle. Okay, so that's the mission. Columbia, Spring. Okay. These like American locations are confusing. Like Spring and 5th. What does that even mean?
Score. Secure the shit out of this place. Boston always had food shortages. Hungry people get desperate. Can you get through?
All right, I got you.
Stay low.
What? I was hiding. What the hell? Thought they couldn't see me, I was hiding.
Yeah, looks that way.
Damn it. That could have gone better.
I think that's all of them. I don't get it. If there were still people around, they would have cleared this place out.
Maybe they didn't make it here.
Yeah, maybe. Let's find that gas.
Latches on the other side. Found the gas. Just need to get back there.
damn it.
Hey, language. Also worship. It's empty. That sucks. Now what? We'll try our luck at the courthouse garage. Let's get out of here.
Well, at least we made it to the church. Where we can all pray our sins away. I have a feeling there's gonna be some kind of fight here. It can't be this easy.
Okay, you were saying? Yeah, so this place brings back a lot of memories. My sister used to drag me to a synagogue all the time.
Do you still pray?
Sometimes.
Really? When?
I said one when we left Jackson. I said one at Joel's grave. Sometimes I just say little ones to myself.
Does it help?
I think it calms me. Helps me put things in perspective. It's a way to deal with grief. A way to show respect. It's what I know.
All right, so how do we get out?
There we go.
This way. Right behind you.
What's this?
Oh, this is the Torah.
The what?
It's scripture. It's like a Jewish Bible. My sister would have flipped for this. The one we used in New Mexico was half burnt. All right. Well, at least I didn't just chuck everything. Think of this.
It might work.
About to do some Tarzan stuff.
Ellie, careful.
It's okay. It's holding. Nothing to it. Come on, Dina.
Right.
70 years ago, my grandfather fled Germany with his family as World War II began. He escaped thanks to the kindness and bravery of a Polish family. And so the wheel turns and the cycle continues. Tonight, my family has packed our belongings, and due to your kindness, we will be leaving this city escorted by your brave men. Thank you for helping me preserve what we could from our shell. It's difficult to leave our home behind, but in the end, it's the people, living people, that matter. You bear a heavy burden on your shoulders, and I hope our late night talks were some sort of comfort to you. If I can leave you...
I hope you got where you were going.
Oh shit, there's more on the back. I forgot to read that. Yeah, let's look at this journal entry. When I think about Joel, all I see is open skin, slack jaw, insides out. I won't let her remember me that way. I'd rather die alone. Did she die alone? Was God with her? Was he with you in the end? Was he with you, Joel? Did I make it worse for you, Joel, being there? Or was I company? He, him, more than I was to him. Damn, Ellie. Beyond faith and path. I want faith through pain. She is out for blood.
5774. Are we in the future?
No, doofus. That's a Hebrew calendar.
For the new year. My sister used to give me an apple dipped in honey. Ugh, now I'm craving it.
Oof, that does sound pretty good.
Jewish holidays are all about food and celebrating not getting annihilated by our enemies. I like coming from a long line of survivors.
Okay, cross the dome off the list.
Still find the courthouse. It might be worth grabbing some supplies before we press on.
Oh, wrong one. Map of Seattle. Okay, the dome is done, and we need to go to 5th and Spring Street, and I think that's it. This horse is so damn loyal. Like, this horse will literally just wait for you.
It's weird being in not hearing trucks, or gunfire and explosions.
My sister always avoided QZs. That's probably why. She just got more and more paranoid. She'd sometimes wake up screaming in the middle of the night.
That's rough.
We always had a bag packed so we could bail if something happened. Never stayed in one place for more than a few weeks. It sucked.
Jotting this down. That's everything. Ooh. Over here.
Goodies. On a crafting bench, nice. Nice, nice, nice.
What have you got there?
Is this gonna be another sad letter? Yep. I heard another runner that was in Westlake Bank has never been searched.
Says there are supplies at
if that's
bank?
True, then it'll be filled with more pre-outbreak supplies. I say we go for it. If there are enough weapons in there, I know some guys that we can trade with for safe passage out of this hellhole. Come on, man. I don't have the balls to go in there by myself, Aaron. Poor guy. Yeah, what's this thing? Oh, it's a scanner thing?
Haven't seen one of these in a while.
Place the tip of device against opposed skin. Push the device firmly until it clicks. Hold in place for 3 seconds. Observe reading on central display. That's the virus checker thing from the first game. I think we're all good now. That is. Oh, that's what that is. See Ellie's version. Shimmer, you move too much. You're quite talented yourself, Ellie.
This must be the music shop.
Man, imagine this place when everything was intact.
They got a bunch of records here. Let's sneak have it.
Damn, that's really well preserved.
What was that?
Nothing. Well, nothing sure sounds nice.
Remember that night by the bonfire?
Yeah. Thank you.
odds and ends, but I'll be stumbling away. Slowly learning life is okay. Say after me, it's no better to be safe than sorry. Take
You should have kissed me then. I wanted to.
Me too.
All right. We should keep moving.
Yeah.
She's got a really good voice. That was beautiful. I really like that cover version. Oh, I can still practice. Nice. Okay. Thank you. May have got a bit carried away there. But yeah, that's my masterpiece. You can buy that on iTunes. Spotify, I think you can on Spotify. I might stream that to YouTube. Got a live concert coming up. Yeah, stick around for that. Oh, can I play the drums now? Oh, please tell me I can play the drums. God damn it. That'd be so fun. Just start our own apocalypse band. I wonder if I hit a drum, would it make a sound? No.
Yo. Check this out.
Wait, what does she get to play the drums and I can't?
Whoa, wow, that was... that was an interesting beat. Excuse me. I am a natural. Admit it. I love you. Whatever. We're starting a band. How about you?
Yeah, yeah.
My groupie.
See, I'm with her on this. Let's start a band.
Fans apparently had these hardcore fans that would just follow them around. Isn't that what I'm already doing? I guess so. Mm-hmm.
Can I not pick this up? Like something important. I guess not.
I don't think there's anything else in here.
Here's your good girl. Yeah, you are.
It's nice to have a place
the
we
best
call
horse.
Home, right? Yeah. When I first got to Jackson, I was so overwhelmed by all the people. I was overwhelmed by all the food. I remember my first week just gorging myself, stuffing food in all my pockets for later, like it was gonna run out. I saw that. You did not. I did. I remember thinking, who is this string bean girl stealing all the jerky? I didn't steal that much jerky. What? What's that shit? Oh, you don't mean... Somebody was camping here.
Looks recent.
Think it was Tommy?
Maybe.
Sign. I think we found the bank.
Should we go explore it?
Your call. This is cool. Oh my god. Holy shit, we might get crushed, kinda way.
Relax. It's probably been like this for years. It's not gonna collapse today. I think.
Not a fan.
Oh shit. Oh shit.
I think these body armor guys were trying to rob the bank.
Oh shit. It's like that movie.
Which one?
The one with the surfer bank robbers.
Oh yeah. Love that movie.
Surfer bank robbers, what? What kind of movies have you been watching?
Here we go.
Bank heist plans. Okay, 60, 23, 06. Ooh, that's a lot of money. St. Parvis. Oh my god, this is an Uncharted reference. That's the ring Nate has around his neck. Sic Parvis Magna. Greatness from small beginnings. That's the ring that Nate has. Oh my god, that's an amazing Easter egg. I love that. That is a really good Easter egg. Let's just take a second to appreciate this. That is so amazing. I love that. Ah, the Easter eggs in this game. Oh, hello.
Thanks, dude.
Pump shotgun, hell yeah. Okay, fuck this. I wasn't even supposed to be here. Fucking Neil roped me in. Said the police would be too busy chasing all those sick people running around. Said this place would be easy pickings. So of course those sick fuckers showed up and everything went to shit. Pulled one of them off Kyle and nearly lost my arm with this fucking bite. And then my own gun locks me in here. My own guys, rather, not his own guns. The cops will be here soon. If I go down, then my friends go down with me. I'll tell the newspapers, tell everyone on TV, that Kyle Peters, Leon Travis, and Neil Grant are motherfucking cowards. Yeah, you tell them. I feel really fucking weird right now, sweating like a pig, arms all red and black where I got bit. Can't keep my thoughts straight. Oh shit, is this how it happens? Am I turning into one of them? Fuck that, I'm going out. I go out like a fucking man. I guess he blew his brains out then.
They tried robbing the bank on outbreak day. Probably seemed smart at the time.
I mean, at the time, maybe. I guess, but... Did I miss something there? No? Is that it? Well, at least we got a new gun.
Agreed.
Oh wow, you took care of her. Nice one. You know what? I don't mind you being here. You're alright, kid. Okay, now let's see. Nope, wrong one. Where's the map? Find the map. Okay, so we've done that, all we need to do is go straight ahead in that direction, and I think that's all the buildings we can explore. I could be wrong.
Hey, if you lived in the village, what would you buy with all that money?
I don't know. Maybe a good farmhouse?
But you can get a farmhouse now.
Okay. What would you get?
A space shuttle?
No, that's right. Your astronaut thing.
Hey, it's cooler than a farmhouse.
Farmhouse is way more practical.
Ooh. That place was crazy. Oh, got a shotgun out of it, so not complaining.
Yep, same.
Okay, let's get to the courthouse. What went down here?
Looks like an ambush. Check out the bullet holes on the side of this truck.
Probably our WLF friends.
Makes you think about the soldiers that are just doing their job. Boom.
Part of the job, I guess. Help me out here.
Maybe we can get in that way.
We could do. But I just want to see what's down here.
This guy was an officer.
Traveling in a ration truck?
Trying to hide, maybe?
Unsuccessfully.
Yeah, sure looks that way.
Everything is in place. We will be waiting. Once we intercept the convoy and take the federal officers captive, you can abandon your post and join us. I know you've taken numerous risks and lived in fear of being discovered. Your loyalty in our cause is appreciated, Isaac. Damn, did not end well for these guys. Okay.
Found the courthouse.
How can you tell?
See that sign up there? On the building that says courthouse?
Nice one.
Oh, well, nice work, detective.
Mm-hmm. Mark this place on the map. Hear that?
I hear it. Infected.
It's coming from the courthouse. This is gonna suck, isn't it?
It is.
We're ready for him.
Thank you.
think so. Go team. Let's find that gas.
Yeah. I wonder what it was like to serve on a jury. But it was fun. Sit down. Look at evidence.
Just give me 5 minutes of my knife. I'll tell you if they were lying or not.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Hey, little help?
Coming. You ever been to a courthouse before?
Nope.
You're telling me you never got in trouble back in Boston?
Oh, I got in trouble. But never landed in a courthouse. Parking garage.
Well, the gas is in there, right?
Well, that's what the note said.
Well, let's get down there.
Oh, wait, do I have to go down here? The following people are top priority targets for any anti-terrorist operations. Emma Patterson, smuggling falsely ration cards, acts of seduction. I can't quite read that. Jason Patterson, Marcus Wilson, Luis Sanchez, Isaac Dixon, Hugo Gonzalez, and Allison Cole. With the Pattersons and Sanchez gone, Dixon has moved to fill in the void. He is now a top priority target. Is this before or after the apocalypse?
Oh shit. This might come in handy.
Oh hell yeah. Oh nice, nice. Reminder, all confiscated all items confiscated should from suspects should be placed in the office lockup code 860722. Do do do.
This guy was a Fedra commander or something. They were losing to the WLF and trying to escape. You don't need a lot if you're that vicious. We need to be careful. Okay, Jesse.
Okay. Despite our best efforts, the Seattle quarantine zone were fought to terrorist group calling themselves Washington Liberal Front. Okay, so that's the LFF. No, WLF. We underestimate their capabilities and lost key cities around the city. We have executed our contingency plans and are now prepping to escort key personnel out of the QZ and 24 hours from now. I intend to stay until the last officer escaped. Let the record show, I provided for this city and its citizens as best as I could. They are now freed. They are now freed of us and are at the mercy of the WLF. Let's see how they feed and shelter the community of thousands. Let them deal with the dissent among their own ranks. Let them deal with those religious fanatics. Inevitably, someone else will come along and hold them accountable for all their perceived wrongs. I almost wish I could be there to see it. Well, oh, what's this? Trainer manuals. Nice. Restores melee weapons to full durability and increases its damage. Nice, nice. Oh, wait, that was on here, wasn't it? Okay, so, 86 07 22. Goodies. Okay, here goes.
That's all of them. Those Fedra guys never even made it out of the garage. And eight. We got gasoline. Our luck's changing. Don't you jinx us. The fuck Fedra Gate is calling to us.
Well, how do we get out of here?
Oh. climbing back up over here. Dina.
Coming. Some supplies before we press on.
Good point.
Yeah, let's go get a coffee. That sounds like a great idea. I like your thinking. New weapon. Hey Davis, check out the old safe houses for supplies. Probably a long shot, but every little bit helps. Grab what you can and meet us back at the Severina. Don't worry about gas, we'll take care of it, Mike. Oh, it's just ammo for his new gun.
Wasn't Joel all about coffee? Kidding me?
You trade half his stuff for a bag of beans.
I never got it. Tastes like burnt shit.
Hey, coffee is really good.
Acquired taste, my ass.
Okay, what's this one? Real name unknown. Big Blue is an extra dimensional entity who has taken on the appearance of a blue whale. First arriving on Earth over a billion years ago to keep watch over the nascent life forms, they use their infinite well of knowledge to help guide the human race in times of great need and upheaval. Their unfathomable age has one major drawback. Days appear to pass as microseconds. However, this time dilation effect is offset if they hold their breath, which they can do for several years at a time. They can hold their breath for several years. Jesus. Jesus Christ. That jump scare actually got me.
Okay? Yeah. How do they get inside these places?
I don't know. I hate that shit.
Ooh, where's that to, Ellie? Okay, so I'm still going back to the gate. We go back, so that was the courthouse, the one before the... okay. They've definitely improved the clicker models, the zombie things. They look a lot more like they used to be human.
Cleared this place out.
Huh. Onward, Shimmer.
How you doing back there? Getting homesick?
A little bit. You?
Same. Just having a roof over my head.
You know, I've always dreamed of fixing up a farm just outside of Jackson.
Why wouldn't you stay in town?
I don't know. I like the idea of real space.
Sounds lonely.
Only if you're doing it alone.
Okay. So are we gonna, like, raise sheep and milk cows?
Are you making fun of me?
No. It actually sounds kinda nice.
Really?
Yeah. Really.
Marcos. Hey, isn't that the key you found?
Got it.
Let's see what we got in here. What the hell is this place?
Some kind of WLF something.
Bare your fangs. Love it.
What is that?
WLF propaganda. Reminds me of the Fireflies in Boston.
In New Mexico, we had these guys called the Ravens. Protectors of the Constitution, they called themselves.
What's this?
Here's their plans to hit that convoy.
Man, WLF just wiped the military out. Way more successful than the Fireflies ever were.
Ghost would have loved this.
Who?
They were these feral cats I had before I came to Jackson. But they didn't seem to want to leave with us, so I miss those scratchy little shits sometimes. Do you have any pets?
Nah, just never really my thing.
Well, maybe when we're done with all this, we can get a nice little creature to take care of.
Alright, deal.
I think that's everything in here.
I think we got everything here.
Hey, you nervous at all?
About?
After everything we found out about the WLF, they seem more organized than I expected.
Doesn't change anything for me. Just means we have to be more careful.
At least they don't know we're coming from.
Exactly. We're gonna be okay.
I know. All right. We should get back to the Fuck Federal Gate before we lose the day.
Yeah. See if we can find those WLF at the Serafina.
Okay, is there any more? Anything else I can explore? Nope. I guess not.
was an adventure. Haven't found any of them yet. Hey, it's a big city. We barely started looking.
Yeah, I know. Just thought we'd see one of them by now.
She's a natural. The code is nope, that's not it. Here we go. And, okay, 53, 45. Okay,
53 and 45. All right. It worked. Well, no welcome, or they're just waiting for us.
Let's look for a way in. Keep an eye on those windows.
WLF. I get it.
Oh, yeah. That makes sense.
Oh. I just got that, too.
You see that?
Oh.
Infected just hopped that fence.
Wait, what?
Oh, means we can get in that way.
Shouldn't we hear gunshots or something?
I don't know what's going on.
I feel like it's pretty empty. I love this machete. This machete is so freaking awesome.
Okay. That's that.
Thank you. Well, what were they munching on?
Ugh. This one's fresh. And he's got one of those wolf patches.
Guess they didn't make it out with the gas after all.
That's good, right?
If those fuckers who killed Joel got taken up by some random infective,
then they'd still be dead, Ellie.
I'm not sure that's justice. Might as well grab what we can while we're here.
Been shot. You recognize him?
No.
Maybe someone else killed these guys. The infected just wandered in.
Hey, found their gas.
Well, we need any more. We know
damn,
how to get it.
That's a lot. Hey, we just passed gas. Get it? Just pass gas. Suit yourself.
Recognize this one either.
Saturday, March 29th. Our strike against the Federal checkpoint worked. Killed at least three of those thugs, just a few wounded on our side. In the wake of our losses, it felt good to hit back. That night, we voted Isaac as the new commander. It was a continuous meeting. His summary execution of those prisoners still doesn't sit right with some people, but I like him. He can make the tough calls. I'm fucking exhausted, but for good reason. We've had 8 new recruits show up in the last few days, and 6 are Federal deserters. Isaac's directive is clearly fucking working. It's either that, or those filers. People are taking us seriously now. Finally seeing Wolf as a real alternative. We'll kick those facets out and rebuild on our foundations. Emma and Jason lied. Oh, laid. Yeah, I guess it probably did lie as well. You never know. Where's that bucket of piss water? Can I knock it over? Come on, I want to spill that. I want to spill that bucket. Jeez. This looks kind of recent, too.
What the fuck happened here? Tommy did this. This?
Wait, but this is all Tommy?
No way. That was definitely him. He's one of the ones that killed Joel.
Damn, Tommy's on a revenge path as well.
Shit, there's another one over here.
What's that say? 7302.
Was using them against each other. How? Joel told me about this. You ask this guy a question, you don't make him say it, you make him write it down. And you ask this guy, and if the facts match, you're telling the truth. No. You fuck him up. Can't be far off. Yeah. Come on. We can get out this way. Maybe catch up with them.
Yeah.
Damn. Tommy shows no mercy. Although we didn't get to see a whole lot of him in Uncharted 1. No, Last of Us 1. So I don't know a whole lot about his character.
I know you said Tommy had a rough past, but fuck.
I know.
Are you okay?
Very fucked up.
It wasn't pretty. I don't want you to think bad of Tommy. Ellie, if I had my sister's killers tied to a chair, I'd do worse.
I hear you.
Nope. Okay, hop on. Okay, I'm on before I leave you behind. There we go, there we go. Nice.
Big question, though. Where does this take us?
Guess we'll find out.
I say we find shelter and we set up camp. Maybe somewhere high up so we can scope out the area.
I like that idea.
Okay. Let's look for an open building.
Preferably with no infected. Or WLF. Wolves. Whatever.
I still have some of those almond things left if you're hungry.
Not really.
You should eat something. Oh my god.
What?
I sounded like my mom just now.
I'll be fine.
Oh! What the fuck? Oh my god.
Get the other! Don't lose her! Go!
Enough!
Oh, the poor horse, no! You bastards. You fucking bastards. How dare you kill our horse? What the fuck? Oh my god. I knew it was running way too smooth. Slapper.
Didn't think I'd ever see you again. How'd you find us?
Asked about a dude with a bitch scar across his face.
It's fine.
How many came with you? Just you two?
You can't stop this.
Jordan! You're supposed to be out looking for the other one. The fuck is this?
You know the smuggler that we killed out in Jackson?
Yeah.
This girl was there.
What?
They're coming after us. That's why Nick was fucked up like that. We gotta get her to Isaac. We gotta tell him exactly what's going on.
Yeah, well, I just got off the radio with Isaac. And we got a new mandate. Kill all trespassers.
Oh, hold up. That doesn't make any sense.
Direct order, man.
No, let's talk to her. Let's figure out what she knows.
I don't give a fuck what she knows. You saw what she did to the others?
You have no idea how many people she might be with. This might be an ambush.
I don't care how many people she's with. We will find them and we'll kill them.
Can you just think for yourself for a quick
Jordan,
second
get the
right
fuck
now?
Out of
can
my
you...
way.
Nina!
Shit, did he shoot her? Don't worry, I'm coming. Hang in there. Sure. Oh, okay, she went short. She just
okay?
Winded.
Mostly. Ellie. We should go. Somebody would have heard the gunshots. Look. She's one of them. Come on. Look at that later. Was there a TV station on that map? I don't fucking know. Come on. Fuck, Ellie. Go around.
Shit.
Did you see? Enough. We gotta get the hell out of here.
She's trapped!
Quick.
Oh, shit. Oh shit. That was my bad, Try and be stealthy this time.
It was this way! Move up! Clear the rooms! Block them off! Don't let him get away!
Don't be stupid! Let him go!
We don't!
Good? Yeah.
You recognize any of these guys?
No.
Oh shit, there's a lot of them.
The hell did they go? Come on, start a sweep. Find them, quick.
That might have been them. I'll check it out. All right, be careful.
There's a lot of them.
I told you. Fuck these wolves. Steal their shit.
What do we got?
Oh, that is really cool.
Adrian's patrol.
I forgot you could do that.
You too. Trespasser's gone.
What?
You seen anything?
No.
Cover this roof. I'll check over here.
You sure she's not on the street? Did you look?
How would she get down there?
I don't know.
Has it been called in? Greg went out to Capitol Hill. He should be back. Guys, any minute.
Damn it. Where'd everyone go?
See anything down there?
No idea. It doesn't feel like it.
Oh hell yeah, look at all these goodies. That could either mean a boss fight or rewards, I don't know. From here on out, kill all trespassers. We will send additional units to locate the other woman. Return to the FOB and EOD. Bring all available supplies.
What about this?
Come on, inside.
Oh, they got tracker dogs as well.
We gotta get away from this school. Now, there has to be a way down the street somewhere.
All right, here we go.
Got it. Come on.
What's this? Cardio. Pedro Rojas was a long-distance runner who dreamed of winning, but always came up short. When Spark offered him a limitless stamina in exchange for using him as test subjects for their new Velocanetium, whatever that is, artificial hearts, he immediately accepted the deal, and then escaped, going into hiding. Now known as Cardio, he can run faster and hard and further than anyone alive. Pursued by Spark, they still want him back to finish their experiments. They just have to catch up to him first. These card things are pretty cool.
We need to get to the street.
Alright, coast looks clear.
Yeah. I think we're good.
Alright. Check this out. She's one of them.
Mm. Well, fuck her then.
Read the letter.
Jordan, Isaac's got us posted up on a 2-week at the TV station. Scars spotted in the area. Here's something to hold you over, Leah.
TV station.
You think she's still there?
We gotta find out, right?
So, spy all these tall buildings. That way.
Let's go get Leah.
You good?
Yeah. Thought I was fucked back there. Thanks for the save, by the way.
Of course. Hey, Nico, how you doing, man?
So, those are the wolves.
How's the game? Oh, the game is really good.
Yeah, they are. Do you think they were gonna meet as many of them? Tommy said this was a possibility.
Oh, good. I'm glad you're doing good.
Does it change anything for you? No.
Yeah, the game's really good. I'm not sure. See you close. Yeah, I am close. I am close. I just need four more.
And once they realize we're out of the school and that we killed their fucking friends, they'll be out in force looking for us.
Yeah, just four more. Hopefully, one day. But yeah, honestly, I do recommend this game. It is really fun. There is a moment I will not spoil, but let's just say I did rage at it. Probably won't play it ever. I don't. Oh, okay, okay. Dina, so you don't mind if it gets spoiled?
I'm ready.
Okay, well. The main character from the last game pretty much got killed off. And yeah, let's just say I wasn't too happy about that. Yeah, you got killed off by someone who I thought she was pretty awesome. That woman who's built like a tank. I thought, god damn, this woman's amazing. And then she goes ahead and kills one of my favorite and main characters in the most brutal way. She bashes his head in with a golf club and forces me to watch. So yeah, that bitch is going down. I never played the game, and I think it's great. Oh, it really is good storytelling. That's one thing Naughty Dog never really fails with, and that's great storytelling. However, it was a shocker. Because like in the trailer, because like this is the main character's girlfriend, and in the trailer it kind of made it seem like she was gonna die and Ellie's path of revenge was to avenge her. I never thought they'd end up killing off Joel. Anyway, how was your stream earlier? Did it go quite well?
Something keeps bugging me. Why didn't they kill you and Tommy when they had the chance?
I don't know.
It seems reckless.
Maybe they're dumb.
Maybe.
I'm invested. A few of my friends are playing this, but honestly, I'd consider it if I get a PS. Yeah, you should definitely get a PS4, or maybe at least like borrow one off a friend.
Could be that you just weren't who they were looking for, so they let you go.
Oh, they did beat the shit out of us. The one guy, Jordan, kicked my face in.
Yeah, but why do you think that they didn't finish?
It doesn't matter. They fucked up.
They did.
But honestly, you should at least like try and borrow a PS4.
The one in the TV station?
Leah.
Is she the one? She the one with the braid?
No. Only thing I remember about her was the sound of her crying over that sadistic fuck's face when I sliced him open.
Oof.
So, how do you want to handle her?
I don't know what she knows.
Oh yeah, yeah. Basically, oh, I'll tell you in a minute. Okay, basically, before this game was released, some hackers hacked into the game, and they managed to leak information about the game. Like, the character who I told you about that died, his death was leaked, However, I managed to keep myself spoiler free. Which I'm actually quite surprised. Like, anything relating to The Last of Us, I just ignored. I didn't even bother looking into it, because I just kept myself spoiler free. However, I knew that streaming it on Twitch would be risky, and I knew that you'd probably get at least one or two trolls that might enter the stream and be like, haha, Joel dies, and then like leave or something like that, you know. So I thought, rather than risk it, I'll just ban any word associated with murder, kill, death, etc. So literally anyone that tries to even remotely spoil the game just won't even get a chance to type it.
Jogging memories of stuff Joel said about his past.
But after I've done this game, I'll unban them.
What are the chances he did stuff that you don't know about?
Hi. He wasn't very big on sharing.
I wonder what Tommy's making of all this.
You probably know. Ooh,
nice catch. Thank you, thank you. I had to take precaution. Makes sense, but story-wise, do you know what her motives would be? At the moment, her motive seems to be revenge. They did actually say before the game came out that the first game was more about like love, and this game's going to be about revenge and how one single act can really affect people. And I kind of thought at first it was Ellie's revenge that they were hinting about. But the main like character that basically killed Joel, she had some major beef with him. He done something to her that really just she couldn't forgive. So I think that the revenge side is more about her, and how her revenge on Joel is triggering a chain of events. That's what I want to know. Nice, nice. All these goodies. Seems like, it does seem like that way. They are really good at their stories. The first one was really good. They also know how to make you cry as well. If you ever watched the intro for the first game, you'd see why. Okay, what's this? Rockefeller trading card. Real estate and construction magnate Norman Striger? Striger? I don't know how to say that. Crowning achievement was the Spark headquarters. Both the part visible to the world and a massive subterranean laboratory complex. But when he walked in on the secret experiment, Laurent tried to dispose of him in a quarry explosion. When the Society of Champions couldn't pull him out of the rocks, Dr. Stem made the rocks a part of him. Now covered head to toe in rock armor, Rockefeller aims to tear the Spark headquarters down brick by brick, and he knows the place better than anyone. Yeah, you keep finding these little like card things around as well. They're quite cool. I think it's based on a comic book one of the writers did. Well, I could be wrong on that. Okay. Thanks for being here, though. I appreciate it, man. Thank you, I will. Cheers for that, man. Okay, so I've been there. Just having a little look around. I'm finding loads of these card things, and this one is Georgina Cunard, a brilliant lawyer with a stringent appearance to the rule of law. Cunard is the best known defense lawyer of heroes who are accused of negligence, excessive force, destruction of property, and reckless endangerment. Feel free to read that for yourself. My brain's a little bit scrambled today.
What are you doing with that?
It's stuck.
Hey, maybe try getting it off the curb.
Oh, that would help. There we go.
Now what are you gonna do with it?
I'll be back in a sec. I'll keep watch.
Okay, Viv, we were robbed last night. It was Jimmy. I hope he acted alone. If you guys are in a rough spot, you can talk to me. I care for you and your son. Now, more than ever, we need to be looking out for each other. There are enough criminals running this city. And flip it. And add a little salt and some water to these, and it almost tastes like the real thing. It's not much, but hopefully it'll help. Get you off to the next drop, at least. Rule, what a weird name.
Is this some kind of bomb?
Trap mines, nice. Hell yeah, I'll take that. take these goodies. Merci, merci.
Was it worth it?
Yeah. Pretty good haul.
Yeah, I got some pretty good things.
I can still kind of see the buildings. How do you want to go?
Let's see.
Shit. I really did try to stealth kill him. Okay, okay.
Any left?
I don't think so.
Good. Shit. You recognize any of them?
None.
Is she gonna carry on asking me that? Do you recognize any of them? Do you recognize any of them? Do you recognize any of them? I don't know. At least a broken ankle.
Thank you. anything in here?
Just Halloween stuff.
Some of this stuff is funny looking.
I'm not a fan.
Oh, nice, a crafting bench. Just what I need. You do that whilst I wasn't crafting. Hey, welcome back, Nico. Welcome back, man. Good to have you back. Get out of the goddamn way. See, that wasn't my fault. Dana got in the way. She wouldn't move out the bloody window. Famous last words.
Hey, Ellie! On your left!
Come on, get down!
Shit. Oh my god, his head! There is nothing left of his head anymore.
There you are. Nice. Come close. Fucking look me in the eye. All right, calm down.
Damn, Ellie.
Well, I wasn't gonna let him live.
No. How many guys did they send looking for you?
That's actually like the first kill I've had like that, where they're like, look me in the eyes. Okay, now can I craft in peace? Or am I gonna get ambushed again? What should I fix? Replace the barrel to fire more powerful shots. That could be good for sniping. That's all I can do. Let me test this out. Nice. How far? I'm not too sure actually. Like, a part of me wants to say halfway, but at the same time I kind of feel like I'm only quarter of the way as well. It's really hard to tell. Especially as soon as I got to this town, it said I got to town, it was like day one, so it could be many days. Yeah, I read up online, and it said, you know, if an average play of this first time would take you at least 25 to 30 hours. So, yeah, there's definitely a lot of gameplay in this. Oh yeah, definitely. Especially because, like, games on release, they're like £50. They're not cheap. Which is why I was a little bit disappointed that Resident Evil 3 was only about 4 hours long. Which is really disappointing because, you know, you don't feel like you're getting your money's worth for £50. Yeah, Resident Evil 3, the remake, is only 4 hours to complete. And it's such a short game, you can actually, there's actually a speedrun trophy for completing it in under 2 hours. I know. It's a good game, I just personally wish it was a bit longer. And they could have made it longer, but they cut quite a bit of content. Yeah, to be fair, the original was quite short. But, I mean, There is ways to make it longer, you know, like the original on PS1 for, like, you know, Resident Evil 1, that was a lot shorter compared to the remake of 1, and that's because they added extra storylines and areas, and, you know, they could have done that. Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah, unfortunately, that's not a new thing for them. It's something they're known for. Fran, it's happening. Early Sunday morning. Keep your people off the streets. But be careful what you say. If Isaac finds out I talked, I'm fucked. Whole thing should be quick. Not a lot of Fedra left in your neighbourhood. As we clear neighbourhoods, we're moving everyone to the base. People shouldn't freak. It's temporary. Help us keep track of the good guys versus bad guys. Can't wait to sleep in the same bed with you again. No more sneaking notes in that stupid studio, Rebecca. Yeah, you know all about it, don't you? Oh yay, another survivor guide. Nice. That kind of looks like a Call of Duty magazine. Craft pistol silencer that makes shots silent. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Silencer is just what I need. Oh wow, she took her out. See, I love this NPC because usually companions in video games aren't always that great. This woman, on the other hand, like, Jesus Christ, she is useful. And I don't say that much about NPCs, but she is bloody useful. And we got another trading card. This one's Dr. Stem. Okay, losing both her parents to cancer at a young age, Yupel Roy threw herself into her science studies, determined to never let anyone experience the same pain and loss she felt as a child. Known as Dr. Stem, she collaborates with doctors and scientists around the world on life-saving and life-enhancing technologies. She also works with the Society of Champions to shut down Spark's more nefarious schemes with technology of her own. Her tendency and refusal to accept defeat is both her greatest strength and her greatest source of torment. Damn, that's pretty dark. Pretty deep and emotional. It's just all the feels, you know. Okay, is that just building for loot? Oh, hell yeah. But three shots, that's not gonna be enough.
Let's try over here.
Did I come in here? Yeah, I was just in that store. Where's that coming from? Oh, there. You don't give a fuck. So, what are the organizations and stuff like in the game? Yeah, it's pretty good. So, up here you've got your health, and you've got a stun grenade and a mine. Here you've got a handgun, sniper rifle, shotgun, throw item, and a Molotov. And you just basically press up, down, left, or right to choose between each one. However, like, when you hover over there, you have to hold on square to, like, swap weapons. But if you find a holster upgrade, you don't need to, you can just, you know, fluidly go left to right. Just pick any gun you want. So yeah, it's pretty good. Easy to craft as well. What's it? I meant like, what's the? Oh, organize. Oh, organization. Sorry, I thought you meant like, as in like inventory organization. To be honest, I don't even know yet. And yeah, you're getting a full UI review. Yeah, yeah, no one actually knows yet. Because the enemies of the first game were the Fireflies, and they wanted to basically bring down the government, and, you know, they said that they wanted to find a cure and all that. This main character, she's immune, so they basically wanted to use her for a cure, but that would have meant killing her, because the virus, the fungus, grows in the brain. So they have to literally just kill her and chop her brain out. But yeah, that was their motives, and these motives we don't know. Trying to build the world in my head without playing. Ah, okay. Yeah, we still don't know the organization yet, and we. Oh shit! I thought if I would stand still, they'd just run past me. Yeah, it's alright, it's alright. I don't really know their motives. They killed Joel, and they seem to have beef with him, but that's about it. Do you know why? No, that's also a big mystery as well. No one knows why she's immune.
Well, hopefully this game
they explain why. Oh, did you see that slide? Shit, 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 shit. Oh, I couldn't move. And also, as you can see in the top left-hand corner, I constantly kept getting notifications, and that kept distracting me. Don't turn around. Nice! Look at her over there, taking charge. Okay. I'm meant to go in here.
It's
Are you gonna play this late? No, not too late. Yeah, I just noticed the time as well. I've been streaming this for about 3 hours, and I streamed about 3 hours earlier, so I've been playing this game for about 6 hours in total. So yeah, I'm probably, once I finish this section, call it a night in this game. And if Mart's still online, I might check out his stream for a bit before I go to bed. Nice, yeah. I'm lurking him right now. Ah, okay, how's his stream going? Okay, turn around. Merci. Okay, there's three of them there. There's one in that building. My bad, there's four there. Am I hyped for any other game? Yeah, I actually am. I'm hyped for Cyberpunk 2077, which unfortunately has been delayed for another couple of months. That's going to be November. And then in December, I'm looking out for Watch Dogs. Because, I don't know, here's the thing. The first two Watch Dogs games, the first one was okay, but it didn't really interest me. The second one, they have improved and I did like it. But the third one just looks insane. Like, the fact you can play as any single NPC and you can actually customize them, they have their own unique voices, own unique dialogue, and it's set in my home country. It's just you know, it just seems really good. No, Terry's not dead.
Sweep this whole fucking place.
Terry's alive. He's all the way over there, where through that bottle.
Right, who the hell's out there?
But sneaker. I have a hard time paying full price for games. I'm with you on that, Nico. Some games are just way too expensive, and if you don't personally feel it's worth it, then, you know, I'd say wait until it's cheaper. There's quite a lot of games that I've wanting to play as well, but I just want to wait for the price to go down. And yeah, Doom Eternal, I've heard good things about that. Patience is great for a game. Exactly, exactly. It's something I've actually been trying to master myself, not only for gaming, but in real life as well, because I can be very impatient. Also, I love how me set a mine there caused a big distraction and caused the... oh, shit. Well, he lost all his limbs. But I mean, like, it caused all the zombies to be like, oh, what's going on over here? And, yeah. They're now lowing men. Happy birthday, buddy. I think it's just the sniper left now. Is that all of them? Hell yeah.
All quiet. You good?
Yeah.
I don't know why, but I keep pressing square to reload. But I keep forgetting that square is the melee attack.
Now what?
So if you ever see me randomly start melee in thin air, it's me just trying to reload but doing the wrong button. Reload meta. Exactly, exactly, Nico.
Let's get up to the second floor.
You know how it is. I play Splitgate sometimes, and instead of switching guns, I reload like a stupid. To be honest, yeah, I do that a lot in video games as well. Oh, just did that again. Or like, instead of reloading, you switch weapons by mistake. But yeah, I've never actually played that game, but I've seen some people stream it. It looks quite cool. I'll take your word for it. I'll give it a go one day. My friends and I love doing custom lobbies and shit talk. Yeah, that's always fun. It's always fun when you've got a group of friends to play stuff like that with. Because sometimes online you can get some toxics or major tryhards. So it's good to go against people who are a little bit more laid back, you know? Or people you can just joke around with. see. It's the closest I've felt to living room water blow in a while. All laughs and stuff. Yeah, that sounds really nice. I think I'm almost done with this segment. The classic blocked upstairs by having all of this here. I should probably for next stream I'll put my mute notifications on my PlayStation, because the annoying thing is, like, I can see notifications on my stream, but because of the blockage thing, on the stream all that comes up is a black box in the left hand corner, which takes up pretty much a lot of the room. Definitely need to mute that, because it is very annoying. So if anyone sees a black box, that's just notifications. It'll be disabled for the next one. It's because I'm in, like, quite a few group chats on PlayStation. So a lot of the time it's like people just messaging each other.
I think it's this
one. Get a PC and a capture card. See, the thing is, I want a capture card, but they're too expensive, and I definitely do need a PC. I've been saying I need a new PC so much. Ardit actually made that a command. See, you did that. Oh yeah, you remember that, you was there with that. I mean one day. They're just very expensive. If you want advice or anything like building PCs. You know, funny enough, Mart's actually saying he's going to help me build a computer. So yeah, it'd be awesome if you could also help as well. Oh, you built his computer? Oh, in real life? Or you, like, taught him the basics or what to do and all that? With him, yes. Oh, okay. You're both in Canada. Do you know each other in person? Oh, he's your... Well, damn, I did not know that. You definitely learn something new every day. See, you're going to finish the game today? Hey, Sebastian. No, I'm probably not going to finish the game. I looked online, and an average playthrough of this game is about 25 to 30 hours, and I'm only 6 hours through, so I've got a fair chunk to go, which, you know, I don't mind. It means I've got something to stream for quite a while, and this game is super fun. I do recommend it if you've got a PS4.
Okay, we got over. Now what?
Yeah, 30 hours. Which I'm glad about, because, like, some games are only about 8 hours, and you, like, because of how expensive they are on release date, you don't really feel like you're getting entirely your money's worth. Okay, I will. Thanks a lot for that, Nico. I do appreciate that, man.
It looks like the TV station.
That is awesome of you.
Yeah. Come on. I don't know how I would have done all this without you. Shut up.
Oh, shit! What the fuck was that?
It ran into a trap.
Oh, damn. Do I have to look out for traps, traps now?
Watch where you're walking.
Damn, this game really likes to fuck you up. And we got another trading card. Macho is streaming the game now too. Oh, okay. I've never actually watched one of his streams. I've heard he's not got to the Joel bit yet. And when he does, I don't. Depend on how he feels about Joel. There may be tears. There may be anger. That's all I'm saying. A beacon of the darkest night. This heroine earned her moniker when people first saw fire emitting from her hands and flowing through her hair. Originally from the volcanic region of France, she fell into an active lava pool while protecting her little brother from Dr. Uckerman's henchmen. Left for dead, she emerged from the pool alive and capable of wielding fire as a weapon. So as long as she doesn't get cold, when she's not working for the Society of Champions, she spends her day hunting Dr. Uckerman, whom she believes is holding her brother captive. Ooh. Someone should make this into some kind of TV series. This silence pistol a try. Oh my god, I saw that and I didn't move away quick enough. I fucking saw. I saw that. Although that's not accurate because I've actually died quite a few times. Okay, and there we go. Wow, I'm such an idiot. I saw that as well. I saw that trap,
I ran into a trap.
I tried moving backwards, but I didn't move backwards in time.
Watch where you're walking.
To ham it. Damn, this silence pistol is no joke. Hey, stop moving. stop moving. Dumb bitch. Damn, that's beautiful. This whole game's been beautiful.
Where are you going? Hey, hold on a second.
Okay, and what's up here? More goodies. Still no scars. 4 more hours of shift. Fuck. Damn, we're gonna need someone to censor this.
Any wolves? I didn't see any, but it's hard to tell.
Okay. I'm gonna slide down here. Sliding in your DMs, like.
Fuck. I'm okay. Come on.
Okay, let me see. Save. And then save, just to make sure. Because I really don't want to be doing this whole section again, so... 1 hour and... Okay, that's good, that's good. Alright, so I'm going to end this here.
My ass hurts.
Thanks a lot for stopping by the stream. I really appreciate that. I really appreciate you watching. Honestly means a lot. Oh, I didn't know there's a photo mode. But yeah, I really do appreciate it. I'll be streaming again tomorrow. And yeah, thanks for watching and see ya.